to also share the good news, the things that make us smile and get us excited across the county. And this morning, we are waking up to the news that the platinum-selling rock band are back. If I lay here, if I just lay.
Happy, and I won't know.
Of the iconic hits from band Snow Patrol there. The group announced today that they will be releasing their new album, The Forest is the Path, on September the 13th. And they're also going to be setting off on a tour next year that's going to be coming through London at the O2 in February. Of course, to tell us more about it is the band's lead singer and guitarist, Gary Lightbody. Joining us on the show, Gary, how are you doing today?
I'm good. Thank you very much, Akylah. How are you doing?
I'm good. Thank you so much for joining us. I mean, listening to your hits like that and then hearing that you're dropping a new album, do you still get sort of like announcement day jitters or anything along those lines?
In the words of the great Robin Williams from Good Will Hunting, thank you for that trip down Amnesia Lane. that was quite a lot of songs you played. I'm a little excited. I'm a little nervous. I'm very, very happy with the way the new records turned out. I can't wait to play some new songs live and all those old songs that you played there as well. I'm really excited for the next phase. It's been a while. It's been 6 years. So
yeah, I was going to say 6 years since the last album. And this is, I want to say, album number 7. Is that right?
It's album number 8.
Album number 8. Right. I do apologise.
No, that's all right. I forget most of the time as well. I just happen to know that in that moment.
I mean, do you remember all the words to everything you've ever written?
No. Anybody that's come to see us play live will know that I don't remember all the lyrics.
Oh gosh!
I'm very glad when the crowd sing along, and anybody that's coming to any of the shows in February, if you'd do me a big favour and sing along, that'd be great.
just to help you out, really. I mean,
yes, it's mainly just to help me out. Yeah,
it's funny hearing you say this, because I'm sure you know by now, Gary, that Snow Patrol have the most listen to song of the 21st century in Chasing Cars.
So far.
Well, I mean,
it's only been 24 years of the 21st century.
True, but it's the song, what was mid 2000s it came out, wasn't it? That's already quite a long time to have that record for. Where were you when you heard that news, and what did you think when you heard it?
Well, I thought they were giving that headline a bit too early, maybe like 75, 80 years too early. But, I think it'll be by the time the century comes to an end, it'll be an Ed Sheeran song or an Adele song. So we're happy to have that record for a while, but we're only holding it for someone else.
That's very kind of you to say, but you never know. I agree. A century is a long time, but you would think that an Ed Sheeran or a Taylor Swift song might have topped it already,
Taylor, no, I'm sure that it will eventually, I have no problem with that at all. It's a beautiful thing to know that people have listened to the song so many times, and it's you know, I hear from fans that it means something to them, and that makes me very happy. A song that was written so long ago, and kind of you never really think when you're writing a song that anyone's going to ever sing along with it, to it, or listen to it. So it's a beautiful thing.
Let's talk about the new album then, The Forest is the Path. What was the inspiration behind this one?
Quite a few things. I wrote an awful lot of lyrics even before we started writing the music for this album, which I'd never done before. So there was a lot on my mind. Time, I think, is the biggest sort of theme on this record. Love too, but again, love from the distance of time. I haven't been in a relationship in a long time. So time and its mischievousness, the fact that we think of it as linear and we can watch seconds and minutes and hours tick away, but you know yourself that it doesn't really mean anything when something dramatic happens in your life. Time will speed up and slow down and everything will feel interminable, or it'll feel like it's rushing away at light speed in moments, and everything sometimes feels like it's happening at once and sometimes things feel like nothing's happening at all. So I was kind of enjoying messing around in that kind of landscape for a while on this record.
And you've really, gone... I was going to say full concept in this album, because you've also done the artwork for it as well. Do you do that for all of your singles?
No. The album artwork is a painting I made, and the single artwork is a painting I made. And I painted a canvas for every song on the record, so at some point they'll all appear somewhere. But yeah, I'm a very novice painter, as anyone can see from looking at it. I paint for fun, and it's very therapeutic and meditative, and I enjoy it. And it kind of just so happened that when I sort of shared it with Nathan and Johnny, I sort of said, is this any, can we use this for anything? And they were both, really happy to use it for artwork on the album. So that's
so multi-talented.
Just another thing, I guess. Well, no, I'm really not.
You mentioned that, Gary, as part of sort of the concept of what you're writing about, love from a distance, a 10-year distance. You'd not been in a relationship for 10 years. Was that a choice? Because I know, choosing celibacy is becoming quite a popular trend at the moment.
I don't think I chose celibacy. I think I just wanted to figure some stuff out on my own. I got sober. I tried to get my head right. It's a lifelong pursuit for me. basically I'm still in that process, I think. So I feel like I'm not really much use to anybody else. So I am until I figure that stuff out. But that's just how I feel right now. That might change.
Well, I wish you the best in your journey.
Thank you very much.
Your latest track, The Beginning, which we do have and we will play, you recorded the vocals in one take, I read. First take, I think, which is incredible.
Yeah, well, that's true. That's something Johnny said in the biog. But there were many, many other songs on the record where it took multiple takes, many, many, many takes. So that was a rarity. That was not that's not very usual. And over a 30-year career, you should hear all the I don't want anyone to hear all the vocal takes that I've done, because it sounds like sort of sea lions on a beach making honking noises.
I'm sure it doesn't. I'm sure you could never sound like that.
I bet it does, actually.
What does it take to get lost in a song that much that you can do it in one take? Does The Beginning hold something quite dear to you?
Well, it was the first song we wrote for the record, myself and Johnny and wrote it that day, and then Nathan put his extraordinary guitar on it, and both Johnny and Nathan were utterly, utterly mind-blowingly extraordinary on this record. Just everything they did seemed to be just golden. That first day, written the lyrics, and then just I was kind of sitting down and just sort of like grabbed the microphone and sung it. So I think, yes, when you're not thinking about it too much, when you're not putting too much pressure on yourself, when it's fresh in your head, sometimes that's a perfect time to record it. And there's so many songs where I probably could have done with doing that over the years rather than sort of going away, writing the lyrics over a long period of time and then stressing about it. It's when you do it in sort of an instinctive mode, it takes all that out of it.
I would have thought, having had the length of career you've had, that you would be in instinctive mode for a lot of the times when you perform or write or sing.
You think, right?
You're still something you're working on.
That's the great thing about the writing process. It is the music writing process. It is instinctive. It's completely instinctive. We write, you know, like we just start from nothing and you just sort of start making noise on an instrument, usually a piano or guitar, and that noise sometimes coalesces into something, you know, tuneful. And then with the lyrics, I would always in the past have taken them away somewhere else and written them over a period of time, as I said. But this time around, Johnny sort of challenged me to write them in the room on the day that we wrote the music, you know, and that was really, I mean, I didn't think that I could do it, and I didn't think it was going to be possible, but it seemed to happen again and again and again. It just got into a rhythm of it. Every time we wrote a song, I'd write the lyrics in the same day. And over the course of the album, then it just creates this momentum, this flow, this energy about the whole thing, that you feel like everything feels spontaneous and alive, and the song never loses its liveness. That it sometimes can do. I mean, the first song on the last album, Wildness, was a song called Life on Earth, and that took me 5 years to write the lyrics to. Obviously, I wasn't trying to write them for that entire time, but I would keep coming back to them, and it just never worked out. So this time around, it was the absolute opposite of that, which is great.
Well, thanks very much for joining us, Gary, and we'll be able to see the liveness when you come through London in your tour early next year. Very well prepared and well organised, by the way. That's some forward planning for you right there.
But yes.
Let's take a listen.
Not my doing, but
of course.
Not the prepared one.
You have people, don't you, Gary? You have people for that.
The record company and the management have done a sterling job, and I'm glad for them for that, because if I was trying to organise a tour, it would not get off the ground.
Well, thankfully, when it comes to songwriting and writing music, it does get off the ground. Let's have a listen to the brand new one from Snow Patrol. It's literally just dropped, and it's called The Beginning.
Love, if you're near, don't tell it like it is, 'cause I don't know how to hear or to learn, 'cause I wanna be in love without being loved in return. But hold me close, 'cause I wanna feel your fire like signals on the coast, and let it rage like the end of everything in this epoch, in this age. There is only you and me in this life, and I don't wanna mess it up now. There is nothing for me in these past lives, there is only what I wasn't yet. And if I made a mess of everything here by being scared of what you give me, I am sorry unequivocally. I just don't know how to love. Let me leave the part of me behind that only wants to grieve, and in this light I can see you as you are, in your frailty and your might. There is only you and me in this life, and I don't want to mess it up now. There is nothing for me in these past lives. I don't wanna mess it up now.
There is nothing for me in these past lives. There is only what I wasn't yet. If I made a mess of everything, dear, by being scared of what you give me, I am sorry unequivocally. I just don't know how to love.
The brand new single from Snow Patrol is called The Beginning. It's from their new album, The Forest Is Apart, their first album in 6 years, which is coming out later on in this year. Both myself and Robin, we're really enjoying that song, actually.
I really liked it.
Yeah, we think the album's going to be really good, so we're going to keep an ear out for it for when it's released. And of course, they are touring through London early 2025.